peoples of the world. Welcome back to our little nature walk here. Let's maybe take a look at these brambles, blackberries here. All the green leaves you can see are blackberries. I would like to get a bit closer, but they are rather stingy, as you might know. And that's something I like about the blackberry. For me, this plant has a certain personality. Let me come back to the personality. Let's take a look at this right here. Here we can see some sprouting going on. Yeah, the blackberry's personality. Because, as I've said, they have stings and they will sting you if you try to crawl into their area. Like right here, let me just take a look at their stings. Here you see it. And it hurts if you really get stuck in their stings. But then again, when they begin to fruit, so when they produce the berries, they really stick them out. They build them new branches with the fruit on the branches, and they will like hand them over to you. So as to say, human, leave me alone, I'm stingy. Let me do my thing right here, doing photosynthesis and getting the minerals out of the earth. And if you leave me alone, I will present you some sweet berries. We will see this in the course over this year, that it is as if they would make this gesture of presenting the fruit to you, because the fruits, these branches with the fruit, they really like stick out of the bramble bushes. So yeah, nothing interesting here. Again, this interesting tree with the honeysuckle. Hope you can see this all right. Listening to the birds. And again, it's a sunny day. Beautiful spring day, but the weather forecast is saying that next week, so in a few days next week, it will be rainy. And then I don't know if I can continue this in such a way if it is heavy raining, but we'll see. Let's just take a look over to this blackberry here. I mean, that's interesting how it grows. You see, it comes out of the ground right there. Then it starts to climb. Climbs, climbs, climbs. Here we have a beautiful large leaf. And they also have stings underneath the leaf. See it right here. Oh yeah, climbs over this tree. Ouch, I'm stuck. So it climbs over this tree here. And it goes down again. So that's what they do. They seek something to climb on, and then they will go back into the ground. And there it is. It reattaches itself into the ground. And grows roots into the ground. Yeah, I mean, this looks rather interesting too. This is a tree that was maybe blown over by the wind or some storm, and then the branches regrow all straight up into the sun. And you can see it. So let's visit our little sekka mutant. See how far it is going. Come on, focus. And by the way, if you want to see some of my photos I take on my tours, you can check out my Instagram. Check it out. Oh, and some people have cut some twigs off here. And I wonder if they really know what they are getting, that it is such a special willow. Oh yeah. I think somebody cut off a rather large piece, because I can't find my little mutant branch, which I always show the people. Never mind, here we can also see the mutation, the so-called fasciation. Yeah, it feels so awesome, so extremely soft. Like you know, some silk or some fine textile, but it is a piece of a plant. Yeah, let's go on. And now this piece of dead tree right here is like freely visible, but in like a month or two this will all be overgrown with different kinds of plants. For example, these rests, or these dead pieces here, these are pieces of nettles. So you can see how large they've grown last year, and they will grow back to this size, of course, this year too. So this will all be covered in nettles. Anyway, the nettles will make up a big part of this little series here, because they grow in absolute abundance. here in my region. There are nettles pretty much everywhere. And soon we'll see some yellow flowers arise from this, from these things here. It looks it looks rather tasty, like a salad. I'm not sure what it is, I have to look it up. But it's in my sources somewhere. Again, all the twiggly chaos of the honeysuckle. So yeah, it will be so interesting to see the transformation from spring to summer to autumn. Because this is really like a barren landscape right now in comparison to its glory in the summer. We have a little birdie. I have to look up the English names. I only know the German names of most birds. Again, a little bit of green there. And there we have a wild tuya. I hope that's the English name too. This coniferous tree that is grown in parks and gardens. Again, let's take a look at the hazel catkins. They open up. Come on, focus. Focus. Focus on my hand. Yeah, and there you can see the pollen on my fingers. This yellow powder. So peaceful and quiet out here, and that's what I love about this little trek here, that it's just a few hundred meters from the main street where I live, but it's so peaceful. And here we have the honeysuckle bush. Again, yeah, and the leaves get bigger and bigger each day, of course. There's nothing to see here. Oh, here we can take a look. It's I don't know the English name. It's Holunder in German, and you can use the fruit and the flowers to make sweet juices. I will mention the name in the title of this video, but I don't know the English name. Yeah, and it's sprouting too. Yeah, you can see it all right. Yeah, it's so interesting. These leaves are, I think, pinnated is the word. They have like more than one main leaf. And it's so interesting to see that they already come out like this from the bud. And then like really spread out.
Sambucus.
So yeah, nothing special today. So I might come back to my little philosophical formula. Life is art, is play. So one asks the question, what is life? My answer would be that life is art and play. Art in the sense of creating something beautiful, something new, building upon the already existing structures and expanding them, and play encapsulates this tendency of drive which is present in nature. Because what is play? What does the playing child, for example, do? It just acts upon certain drives. If you really like are caught up in a play, you're not doing it consciously. You're just acting it out, you know? That's what I mean with this play aspect. Life is art, it's play. So yeah, that's all for today, guys. I hope you can enjoy the silence and the peacefulness which lays in this little patch of land here. Okay, see you guys next time. Bye-bye.